tri-state forecast that's independently certified most accurate. Here's Chief Meteorologist Kevin Robinson.
All right, Power 5 Live radar tonight is on a clean sweep. The good news is that you can actually put your rain or put your umbrellas away for the next couple of days. We've probably got two decent days here before the chance for showers returns to the forecast by the time we get to Thursday. We were able to actually see just a little bit of the sun tonight before it actually went away and the cloud cover moved out of here. 65 is where we're at right now at the airport. We've got a light southerly wind, but keep an eye on these two numbers overnight, the dew point and the humidity. Look at that, up there near 90%. There's still a lot of moisture in the air. And with the winds relatively light tonight, I wouldn't be at all surprised if there was a little bit in the way of patchy fog developing towards morning. Here's kind of what to expect as we go through the next couple of days. Tuesday and Wednesday look like two very decent days for us. And then I'm still eyeing at the end of the week a pretty strong cold front. Now that we're about to slide into the month of October, we really are about to get into those transitional fronts that are quite strong and can bring some really cool air behind them. Tonight, we've gotten rid of a lot of the cloud cover, but if you notice, there's still some patches of gray out there. There may be some dense fog again towards morning. What I want to draw your attention to is, though, what's happening here in the Pacific Northwest. One surefire way you know that fall has now arrived here, you've got some pretty potent storms crashing into the Pacific Northwest, and they will organize and eventually bring a strong cold front and maybe some storms to us by the end of the week. Tonight, temperatures generally in the 60s, a few upper 50s out there. 64 in Dayton, is 63 in Indy, 67 in Louisville, again 65 here in Cincinnati. By morning, most areas will be down into the middle and upper 50s, between about 55 and 60. Of course, your typically cool spots, Wilmington down to 55, Hamilton at 56, Brookville 55, about 59 over in Florence. And then tomorrow, with plenty of sunshine, afternoon highs will be warmer than they were today. We should climb our way into the upper 70s, maybe not knocking on the door of 80 in a few places, about 80 in Florence, Vivi at 80, 77 in Wilmington, 78 over around Hillsboro. So high pressure has basically scoured out a lot of the cloud cover here in the tri-state. We may again start with a little fog in the morning, but then this high basically will dominate our weather Tuesday and into Wednesday. All the while, a warm front will be organizing to our south and west, and by the time we get into Thursday, this warm front will begin to approach the tri-state and bring back the threat for showers, and then we will have to await the arrival of that cold front that's way on the west coast tonight to bring in some showers and storms, followed by cooler weather. So for tonight, 57 the overnight low. The skies have pretty much cleared already, so patchy dense fog towards morning. And then for tomorrow, partly cloudy. It should be quite warm. We'll make it into the upper 70s. Here's your day planner. Maybe a little bit of fog to start, so you certainly want to check in with the forecast in the morning, see if you need to leave yourself some extra time. And then there we go, noon up to 73, by 5 o'clock up to 79. And here is your 7-day forecast. It looks like Wednesday probably going to be the nicest day of the week. Friday won't be terribly bad right now, but the timing on that cold front still out. So it's either Friday or early Saturday when we should see a decent round of showers and thunderstorms, followed by some much cooler weather, as you can see that 79 to 65 by